Hey guys, welcome to another commentary done by Diggity. Bottom left hand corner, we've got Snow starting as the blue Protoss. Bottom right hand corner, we've got Kwe, aka Fantasy, starting as the orange Terran. This is going to be the second match between these two in this many weeks. I'll see if I can find some other Snow replays. I am not seeing any new Flash replays as of late, at least on ladder. This is on Nemesis, in case you guys have forgotten it. It's been a minute. You've got, I'm remembering it now. I had to remind myself, you got the big natural expansion, that high ground up here. You've got these simulators at all corners of the bases, which can then, if I can get rid of there, that's what I want to get rid of. And then zoom in, you can see where you got the eggs that you can take down. If both eggs are opened up, you can get small units through, I believe. If you take down one assimilator, or sorry, if you take down both eggs, units can get through. If you take down one assimilator, small units can get through. If you take down both assimilators, it is only ghosts that can get through. So, we'll have to see how this plays out. In the first match that I saw between these two on the ladder, it was a ferocious attack from Fantasy that was unrelenting that Snow was able to push back. Snow, about as strong a Protoss player you'll see these days. There has been a new build out on the ladder, which involves a 9 supply depot and a 9 barracks, I believe, something along those lines. Doesn't look like that's what we're seeing right off the bat. Get that back up here from Fantasy instead of going for that 11 barracks. We'll see if he goes straight into expansion. But Snow, on occasion, just because he's such a fantastic player, stereotypical Protoss, have been building the initial Zealot just to shut down a lot of options. Looks like we're seeing Gas versus... Yeah, it's definitely Fantasy. Fantasy's one of those guys who likes opening up with his early factory play and then playing kind of an adjustment game from there. Initial probe moving out to get some scouting information. Looks like SCV is making its way out as well. Let's see if the SCV makes its way. Is it going to go north? It's going to go north. So missing that probe. Actually, once that probe shows itself, I'm expecting that SCV to shift positions, but we are seeing a skip of that first Zealot, and I think that's just something that Snow can pull off and not a lot of other Protoss can pull off. He's going to sneak in, get first scout in the base, harass that SCV already, taking a little bit of damage to start. It's incredible. Just, I'm going to say, like, so first of all, there's a decent amount of harassment that happened there, but just the fact he got the shots off and the probe he did is a testament to Fantasy's micromanagement. So now that Marine out, going to push that back. We are seeing the adjustment of the SCV. And two pylons in base, no third pylon as of yet. I'm expecting a potentially a first Dragoon, but upon what was scouted, we'll have to see what Snow opts to do. I'm wondering if he got a good look at the amount of gas being mined, but not able to deny this initial scout from Fantasy. Fantasy taking some damage. And really, you can see Snow getting to work on that SCV. Does not want to let it linger. So potentially, and with that, that makes me think that he really wants to open up robotics first, or at least shut down any sort of scouting information. So he's got a probe in position to maybe drop that Nexus. SCV's exited to the north. We already got three Marines down here. With a fourth Marine, we'll see if the Marines continue to be constructed. SCVs are back on gas with the machine shop and factory down. So this could turn into some aggression. Marines are forward currently, one Marine lagging. So just seeing the three Marines would be enough to dissuade the Dragoon. But seeing the four Marines has got to put Snow on alert. And he has dropped the Nexus behind that. So gone one gate into Nexus. He's got range upgrading. We'll have two Dragoons. And we'll see, yeah, we got five Marines waiting, so I'm wondering if it's going to be that Marine Vulture push that's been, I've seen here and there. It looks like a siege tank getting started, some mines being upgraded, so it looks like actually just standard potential FD overall. Snow trying to abuse the high ground, low ground here to get as many pot shots as he can against here. He's already damaged at least two of the Marines, two more Marines waiting in reserve. And Fantasy holding the four to the front as though he's going to drop a bunker, but I think Snow has to know there's aggression coming. Getting an additional shot off. Now sees the bunch of Marines, so absolutely knows. And how many Marines are we looking at here? It looks like we're going to see seven overall and a siege tank starting to push out with a Vulture to follow and then a command center to plop down once the Vultures are on their way. Shield battery on the front to provide some additional defense. Looks like we've got two Dragoons already up there. We also have that SCV in the pot in the window waiting to maybe join this attack force. So a couple additional hits. Every hit matters. Some Marines have already been hitting away, but that siege tank has gotten a lot of free shots on that Ford Dragoon, has already gone into the shield. Shield immediately replenished on that shield battery. And now, probes pulling off the line briefly and scooting right back. There has been a mine drop. It looks like it's going to be solid right this second. Two mines planted on the Ford. It looks like one of them got picked off. The Vulture's gone. The siege tank is at somewhat risk. Not a lot of defense force, or I should say attack forces left from Fantasy. Another mine gets swatted. But we do have a little bit of mine on the forward field, which is allowing the siege tank to get a few additional pot shots. It's going to start working on that pylon. But otherwise, that attack mostly squashed. Another Vulture making its way up. No Dragoons. Looks like some Dragoons have taken some base damage, but no Dragoon kills overall. Excellent defense from Snow. Just some mines being built. Command Center is going to be finished, but once a robotics facility, we're seeing a gateway flood, the robo's already up, an observer's on the way, and I'm a little bit concerned for Fantasy's ability to counter-defend here, putting Snow in the red after getting that pylon, happy to take that damage and back off. The Vulture's going to exit to the north. Do we have speed upgrading? No, we have siege tech upgrading behind us, a second factory plop down. But I wouldn't be shocked if Snow leaves a Dragoon or two behind. Interesting, they want to go for a run-by, maybe to that opposite location. Let's see if that probe is able to get position on them. But now that these mines are gone, we've got two siege tanks to defend the front door, no bunker, no marine support, and that's five Dragoons. And once some additional Dragoons are out here, I would not be shocked to see Snow go up and try to hunt some siege tanks on the front. I see you kind of sneaking out to the corner. We do have plus one weapons starting up. The Academy dropping as well, second machine shop on the way. And what is this? Snow immediately going for a 9 o'clock Nexus. Did he even scout the Vultures here? I don't know that he scouted those Vultures. Three siege tanks on the near wall. That is going to keep those Dragoons back. It looks like the Observer spotted it, so not going to take the free shot, but the probe. So okay, one Vulture, the Vulture is going to be able to see that 9 o'clock Nexus. That's going to be a big indicator that this is going to be more of an economic, I mean, that's just huge, absolutely huge. And the Vulture able to squirrel around a little bit more. I don't know that it's going to get a lot else out of this. I'm just surprised it's still alive, finally getting wiped out. Looks like that other Vulture exited to the top left-hand corner, but we'll see now how Fantasy wants to play this. He is getting Vulture speed and fielding a few additional Vultures despite having the double machine shop, feeling safe with the five siege tanks he's got on the front overall. Wonder if he's going to go for another shot at this. I hear some Dragoon fire. Looks like he's going to go ahead and... So letting the probes across is going to go ahead and probably seal... Take out these assimilators to make it a little bit more defensible at the 9 o'clock location. And we'll see if Fantasy is going to try to macro it up and maybe sneak into a third base a little bit earlier himself. Or if he's just going to play... It's possible he's going to go for a timing, but if he's going for the timing, I would expect more than just the third factory being plopped down. There is a preventative Goliath as well as Charon booster being upgraded just in case there was a shuttle and Reaver, and it looks like we do have a Reaver inside the shuttle. No follow-up shuttle speed as of yet. I think these are defensive Reavers rather than offensive Reavers overall. Observers checking out to the north, and we do see a starport being built up to that northern corner. And the eggs being wiped out to maybe go for a 3 o'clock base grab comparatively. The eggs being opened up by Fantasy to that 9 o'clock base. And right now, not a lot of defense, and I don't think that's been spotted as of yet. So that might end up, that might result in a couple of hits. But right now, it's just macro fest. Snow has gotten the supply lead he's looking for, but, and he is a little bit ahead in workers, but not in such a domineering situation that he could feel safe about it. So Dragoon eating a shot right there. Looks like that's going to be a big indicator that's even a fourth base being grabbed overall. Plus one weapons is just now finishing. It's just three factories, which suggests it's going to be, again, more defensive play overall from Fantasy and more the long-term macro game. But the egg just about to get wiped out. It's still going to be a single-shotting Vulture, but this could still be a good amount of harassment. It looks like the fourth Nexus being dropped, some additional defensive pylons, but so that's been opened up. I'm wondering if some more units are going to make their way that direction. Also, counter pressure opposite side, Snow opening up the eggs. So the Vulture's trying to take down the assimilators so the Dragoons can't get through. They were making a race to try to take some eggs down. It looks like they're going to give up on that. The shuttle moving to the north with the Reaver to get some pot shot kills. It looks like on those vultures overall. I might have, I don't think I missed a drop at the natural. A lot of Goliaths right there, a dropship being built as well. And now the Reaver actually going for the Assimilator, gonna try to box Fantasy in. Vulture still remaining steady there at the 9 o'clock. I'm just gonna try to keep an eye on that back corner. So Snow going up to four bases. He's taken one Assimilator down, which is gonna make it a lot harder for that 3 o'clock base to get grabbed. The Observer being swatted on the front. Snow chasing some units right back in, staying, doing a great job of staying on the perimeter of that attack. Dropship has been fielded, but here's the thing. Snow knew this dropship was, I mean, he had an Observer over that line a long time ago. We've got five factories making our way to plus two weapons. Do we have a second armory out? No second armory as of yet. So I don't know if we're even gonna go for 3-2. Pylon in the forward field, there is a cannon over that natural expansion, but the Dragoon, it looks like some probes cycling out, mostly just Zealots to maybe defend this. And they aren't speed upgraded as of yet. So two being dropped here, it looks like the probes, so a few probes getting killed. And the Zealots marching back, that's not the matchup you want. So Zealots probably gonna lose their lives. There is a defensive cannon, see if I can take that down for you. There is a defensive cannon, and now that Vulture trapped in the bottom left-hand corner, getting wiped out otherwise. But this is putting Snow in a fantastic position where, yeah, he lost a few probes here and there, but he's got four bases that are fairly well saturated. It's going to be a while before that main gets anywhere near depleted. He's got Fantasy pretty well boxed in, and ooh, that could, if these Goliaths need to play very far forward here and stay alive, because that, this clumping of siege tanks is scarab bait. Looks like the Reaver's already taken a bit of damage here and there. But this is locking Fantasy to two bases, Snow sitting on four, and he's already opened up a 30 supply lead. And on top of that, so we have the 6 o'clock base, he can expand into his opponent, but expanding to that 3 o'clock, a little bit more challenging, again, because of that Vespine Geyser that's been taken down. Vulture finally active, but after all that time waiting, manages to get up two probes, and detected otherwise. Looks like another secondary drop went all the way across the northern corridor. There's three photon cannons there. The Dragoon's gonna get wiped out. It's gonna be a while before the Zealots are able to march up there, provide some support. So at the very least, Fantasy able to get some counter damage done. The Worker lead still in his opponent's favor, however. Some mines clearing things out, but it looks like the Zealots are in fact, yeah, able to get there. The Vulture's sneaking back through. There's that cannon still waiting there. It looks like the Zealot just going to clear the mine that was left otherwise. A gateway already in position. But Fantasy not missing a beat. So he's saying like, okay, I'm not able to make a lot of progress there. Let me start moving out and at least get a wedge towards the front here. Reaver very low on health, but still able to get some shots overall. An Observer getting taken out to the south. Science Vessel is there. Some more Vultures fielding out. But right now, Snow in a really crushingly strong position. The Vulture's not even able to slide through the Zealot lines right there. So we've got a few mines being dropped. Where's the Observer? See if the Observer is able to peek back out. There's a command center that's been constructed, but Fantasy doesn't want to grab for that 3 o'clock, especially with those Reavers in the open field, because he'd have some trouble defending it. Two photon cannons defending, that's keeping the Vultures on the perimeter, a Dark Templar being produced to maybe support that, and another drop of two siege tanks going to move in to try to take down, or at least cripple, this upper left-hand base. The Dragoons continuing to funnel Fantasy's troop. He's had to go for a very slow extension right there to push out. Tanks now sieging. That should create serious damage. Another Nexus being dropped bottom left, but the Reaver's right there as far as a follow-up drop to clear things up, and that plus the Dark Templar able to clear things out. So now things looking real scary for Fantasy. This is his third that he's having to float at a great distance. Maybe he can send SCVs all the way up that right-hand alleyway through the mineral patches to at least do that. Ooh, probe gonna get picked off. The Vultures have been fairly active. Still that cannon along the edge. He can maybe, he's done a really good job of keeping the worker count low. He's ahead, but it doesn't matter that he's ahead because he's been mining off two bases versus really a significant, I mean, Snow looks like a Zerg player right here, hitting max as Fantasy is just hitting 70 supplies. Siege tank on the high ground. These are mitigatable losses, though. Dragoons are being pushed off the front. Maybe we'll see a quick two-base take. Reavers redropping. Go ahead and clear out that 9 o'clock. Reavers have been fantastic. A big clumping of siege tanks. It looks like there is a second... There's got to be a second armory someplace. There's a second armory. I just missed it earlier. Because this is kind of the 3-2 push. But Snow peeking up. It looks like he's found that command center. So all of that travel distance just to immediately lift off and try to exit. And it'll honestly be lucky if it doesn't get wiped out. There's also a huge stream of zealots. And wow, that Psy Storm over those siege tanks. Look at the battering that army's taking. The command center taking massive damage, might be able to sneak out. It's burning. I don't know that an SCV's going to be able to repair it. And the zealots chasing down those siege tanks. And Psy Storm coating them the entire way. The dropship lagging behind this. Pummeling right there. It looks like a few, at least some mine shots following things up. A very measly 5 vultures sneaking through, creating a very weak mine coverage. The zealots, of course, just gonna absorb a lot of that. Well, it took out a good amount of zealots, so that's something at the very least. But Fantasy can afford to play sloppy right here. Oh, luck right here, though. Gonna catch a probe line. The Reavers scrambling back, High Templar as well, to try to defend this. It looks like he is able to protect that overall. Few mines will be able to see at least those probes transferring, but peeling off the main, the natural expansion, resources are being left there. Snow's saying, you know what? I've got such an economic lead, I might as well mine at the more disadvantaged locations than try to engage heads up. Fantasy moving out at the very least. He's got some sizable upgrades, plus 2 weapons out there for Fantasy in comparison. He's gonna have to land that command center and build an SCV shortly. The Dragoon's really piling in. Looks like the science vessel getting wiped out on the front as well. Heard that noise in the background. The Dragoons have... looks like Fantasy are getting a slight advantage of Snow playing a little bit sloppy as far as turnarounds, but honestly, this is a huge, huge deficit to try to recover from. SCV's trying to get built. There's a dark, is that Dark Templar going to go through? That would be the worst. But you get the big open field now, all sorts of mines, some siege tanks still sitting at the main, another command center being built, I assume, to float at the 3 o'clock location, a ninja base now being repaired at that 12 o'clock, although a Dark Templar looks like it's going to be right there and not too long, but with a wall of mines, maybe Fantasy is sealed off a bit for that right-hand side. At this stage, I haven't seen a transition to late-game carriers. I don't see a lot of dropships. It's still mostly just Dragoons and Zealots to try to clear a lot of this. Dark Templar able to get in, going to get some of those additional SCV kills. The Dragoon's going to get pushed off the front. Kind of looking for where Snow's attack forces are right this second. He's near max supply. Command center continuing to take damage to the north. It looks like he's just kind of boxing him in, letting him starve out. The main is gone, so no resources there. Very few resources at the natural expansion. A command center looks like it's going to try to float to the 6 o'clock to try to hold that. Snow continuing to box in. It looks like is he going to sneak in and check? I think he's hovering the corner there. I'm wondering if he's going to check that 3 o'clock base to see if it's up and running. Yeah, so finding 3 o'clock, nothing there. Observer now checking the 6 o'clock, sees the SCVs making their way that direction. He knows, okay, that's most likely the next location. I'm shocked. This is Fantasy not GGing is really what it comes down to. And this might turn into an Artosis-style situation where if you saw that game versus him versus DeWalt where Snow was expecting a GG earlier and so is just kind of hanging out in the game and playing a little bit lackadaisically, a little bit of Miss Sidestorm right there. But this game is Snow's locked and Command Center once again under fire now. So right now, that's all the resources Fantasy has. He's distance mining at the 6 o'clock, moving into Command Center right there. More Psy Storm. Level 3 weapons, level 2 armor at the very least. He's starting to push towards that bottom left-hand corner. Another grouping of a bunch of High Templar there waiting. It looks like we've got some more shuttles waiting as well. This feels... Yeah, it should have GG'd a while ago, to be honest. So, okay, some mines being cleared on the front. Nothing in the bank. So, Fantasy just pushing up and trying to attack with what's left. High Templar dropping it and getting the Psy Storms on the corner. I'm wondering, it looks like he has some Dragoons actually wiping out the eggs in between to counterattack and get that 6 o'clock location. I will say this, at least Fantasy's created a sizable wedge, but it feels like Snow's just kind of toying with him at this stage, drawing the forces out. He's got a huge army just kind of waiting right there. The Dragoons have managed to get through. They're pummeling the 6 o'clock location. That's sending all of the siege tanks through. They got to clear through their own eggs to get here, and they're going to be greeted by an army that might have a high ground advantage. Fantasy's still mining there because he has to, and now Snow dropping some size storm to the rear. It looks like there are some siege tanks to at least cover that back edge. Gonna try to siege over that assimilator wall, and some High Templar moving in. Still no GG as this base getting wiped out. Defense Matrix meeting some size storm there to the north. It looks like a Zealot able to wander up, and that command center's probably gonna drop to the Dragoons. Ooh, more beautiful size storm to the north. And now Fantasy supply plummeting. Playing this like it's a tournament game. Really does not want a GG here. He's got 6 siege tanks to his name, maybe? Yeah, those are his final 6 siege tanks. And he's got 6 siege tanks, 2 science vessels versus a max Protoss army that's still got a lot of Psy Storm waiting for him. Mostly there. Final dive by Fantasy into the natural expansion. Psystorm dropping all the way. The tanks remaining sieged, but still eating a lot of Psystorm as the Dragoons are piling into it. There's GG finally. Hope you guys enjoyed it overall. Fantasy trying to turn to form, but thus far hitting the wall that it is snowed. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks for listening.